Welcome to Jeremy's IT Lab. This is a free, complete course for the CCNA. If you like these videos, please subscribe to follow along with the series. Also, please like and leave a comment, and share the video to help spread this free series of videos. Thanks for your help. Also, remember to download this practice lab from the link in the description and try it out yourself in Packet Tracer. In this lab, we will practice some basic VLAN configurations, specifically, configuring access ports on a Cisco switch, which is what was covered in Day 16's lecture video. As I said in that video, an access port belongs to a single VLAN, and a switch won't forward frames between VLANs directly. It must send it to a router first. This network here is very much like the one I used for the demonstration in the lecture video, featuring three VLANs. VLAN 10, the engineering department, VLAN 20, the HR department, and VLAN 30, the sales department. Let's get started with step one. First up, we must configure the correct IP address and subnet mask on each PC, and we must set the gateway address as the last usable address of the subnet. We will later configure that address on R1, as it will be the default gateway for each subnet. So let's go on PC1 first. From the Config tab, let's enter the gateway address first. The last usable address for PC1 subnet is 10.0.0.62, so that will be the default gateway of the subnet, R1's address. Next, click on the network interface here, and set the IP address of 10.0.0.1. Hit Tab, and then adjust the subnet mask to 255.255.255.192, because it's a /26 subnet. Okay, that's all for PC1. I'll quickly run through the other PCs now. PC2 is next. Go to the Config tab, gateway address of 10.0.0.62, go to the network interface, IP address of 10.0.0.2, and subnet mask of 255.255.255.192. Okay, that's all for the VLAN 10 PCs. Next is VLAN 20, so I'll go on PC3. Config, set the gateway address of 10.0.0.126, the last usable address of the subnet, then configure the network interface. Address of 10.0.0.65, subnet mask 255.255.255.192. Okay, now let's go to PC4. Config, gateway address of 10.0.0.126, then let's configure Fast Ethernet 0. IP address of 10.0.0.66, subnet mask of 255.255.255.192. Okay, those are the PCs in VLAN 20. Finally, let's configure PC5 and PC6 in VLAN 30. PC5 first. In the Config tab, set the gateway address to 10.0.0.190, which is the last usable address of the subnet. Then set PC5's IP address to 10.0.0.129 and subnet mask of 255.255.255.192. Okay, finally, let's go on PC6. Set the gateway address of 10.0.0.190, and PC6's IP address is 10.0.0.130, and the subnet mask is, once again, 255.255.255.192, or /26. Okay, so we've configured all of the PCs. That's step one complete. Step two is to make three connections between R1 and Switch 1, and configure one interface on R1 for each VLAN. So I'll click down here for the connections, and select a straight-through cable. I've already put the interface labels on the network diagram. Switch 1's G01 to R1, G00, etc. So let's do that. Switch 1, G01 to R1, G00. Next is switch 1, G11 to R1, G01. And then switch 1, G21 to R1, G02. Okay, we've made three connections. Now let's configure R1. Hop onto the CLI, and then enter privileged exec mode with enable, and then global config mode with configure terminal. Okay, I'll configure G00 for VLAN 10, G01 for VLAN 20, and G02 for VLAN 30. So, interface G00. We must assign the same IP addresses that we configured as the gateway addresses for each PC. Here in VLAN 10, that is, IP address 10.0.0.62, 255.255.255.192. Then enable the interface with no shutdown. Okay, next up, G01. Interface G01. The gateway address for VLAN 20 is IP address 10.0.0.126, 255.255.255.192. No shutdown. Okay, now G02. Interface G02. The gateway address for VLAN 30 is IP address 10.0.0.190, 255.255.255.192. No shutdown. Okay, let's confirm with a quick show command. Do show IP interface brief. There are the three gateway addresses we configured for each VLAN. Looks good. For step 3, let's configure switch 1's interfaces. Go onto the CLI of switch 1. Enable, and then configure terminal. Okay, now let's configure the three VLAN 10 interfaces at once, like this. Interface range G01, comma, F31, comma, F41. Now we are configuring all three interfaces at once. Let's configure the interfaces as access ports with this command, switchport mode access. It should enter that mode by default, but it's best to manually configure it. Remember, an access port belongs to a single VLAN, as opposed to trunk ports, which we will cover in day 17's lecture video. Next, let's assign the VLAN. Switchport access VLAN 10. Okay, that's it. Let's go on to VLAN 20. Interface range G11, comma, F51, comma, F61. Switchport mode access. Switchport access VLAN 20. Okay, finally, let's do VLAN 30. Interface range G21, comma, F71, comma, F81. Switchport mode access. Switchport access VLAN 30. Let's check it out. Do show VLAN brief. Okay, our VLANs were created and the interfaces were assigned to the correct VLANs. But let's also change the VLAN names now. VLAN 10. Name, engineering. VLAN 20. Name, HR. VLAN 30. Name, sales. And let's check once more. Do show VLAN brief. Okay, the names have been changed. That's all for step 3. Finally, let's test connectivity. I'll do some pings from PC1. Okay, go onto the CLI of PC1. And first I'll ping to complete the ARP process. Let's ping to PC3 in VLAN 20. Ping 10.0.0.65. Okay, so we can reach PC3. Next, let's ping PC5 in VLAN 30. Ping 10.0.0.129. Okay, we can reach PC5 as well. Now let's go in simulation mode and ping PC3 again. Okay, let's do that ping. Ping 10.0.0.65. Okay, so PC1 sends the ping to switch 1, then it goes to R1, then back to switch 1, then to PC3. And the return follows the same path. So R1 is doing the inter-VLAN routing for us, because it has one interface in each VLAN. Okay, let's do one more test. I'll ping VLAN 10's broadcast IP, which is 10.0.0.63, and let's see if the broadcast only goes to devices in VLAN 10, as it should. Let's try. Ping 10.0.0.63. Okay, there we go. It is sent to switch 1, which then forwards it only to R1 and PC2. Okay, in this lab we did basic configuration of access ports on a Cisco switch. That's all for this lab. Thank you for watching. Please subscribe to the channel, like the video, leave a comment, and share the video with anyone else studying for the CCNA. If you want to leave a tip, check the links in the description. I'm also a Brave verified publisher and accept BAT or Basic Attention Token tips via the Brave browser. That's all for now.